Welcome to iaosius.com Food Tech Club. Today's topic is medicinal and aromatic plants. Plants may have bioactive constituents like alkaloids, glycosides, steroids, phenols, tannin, antioxidants, and other groups of compounds which may have marked pharmaceutical actions as anti-cancerous, anti-malarial, anti-almantic, etc. Many of these essential oils, dyes, latex, and even vegetable oils are also widely used as medicines. Many substances that go into making up medicines are frequently the products of living cells, although seemingly waste or intermediate metabolic compounds and not an integral part of the protoplasm and may have no obvious utility to the plants. Out of nearly 450,000 species of higher plants available, only a small proportion have been investigated for medicinal properties, and still a smaller number of plants yield well-defined drugs. The same is the case with lower plants and with plants of sea origin. Thus, the knowledge of plant constituents gained so far is still meager, considering the huge number of species available in the world. Approximately only 10% of the organic constituents of plants are reported to be known, and the remaining 90% are yet to be explored. Drugs are derived from trees, shrubs, herbs, and even more primitive kinds of plants which do not fall into these categories. They are made from fruits, leaves, stems, roots, and even bark, and even seeds. Archaeological discoveries from 60,000-year-old Neanderthal burial grounds in Iraq point to the use of several plants like marshmallow, yarrow, and groundsel that still figure in folk medicine. Mexican Indians are reported to have used peyote cactus for its hallucinogenic and also possibly its healing properties for thousands of years. This plant is now known to have antibiotic properties as well. The practices of indigenous systems of medicine in India are based mainly on the use of plants. Charaka Samhita, 1000 BC to 100 AD, records the use of 2000 plants for remedies. Ancient medicine was not solely based on empiricism, and this is evident from the fact that some medicinal plants which were used in ancient times still have their place in modern therapy. Thus, for example, ephedra, a plant used in China 4000 years ago, is still mentioned in modern pharmacopoeia as a source of important drug ephedrine. The plant sarpaganda, Revolvia serpentina, which was well known in India as a remedy for insanity, is in existence today for curing mental ailments. Quinine, another important anti-malarial drug of modern medicine, was obtained from the cinchona tree. The future prospects of the medicinal plants is like the World Health Organization. They have emphasized the need for better utilization of the indigenous system of medicine based on the locally available medicinal plants in the developing countries. In the USA and UK, plant-based drugs are being used in recent years on a considerable scale. The former USSR countries, East European countries, and China have adopted an integrated system of allopathic, traditional, and folk systems of medicine. During the last two decades, there has been a tremendous transformation of medical systems in the world. Owing to the realization of the toxicity associated with the use of antibiotics and synthetic drugs, Western countries are increasingly aware of the fact that drugs from natural sources are far more safer. Therefore, there is an upsurge in the use of plant-derived products. Medicinal plants and their derivatives will continue to play a major role in medical therapy in spite of advances in chemical technology and the appearance of cheap, synthesized complex molecules, from simple ones through highly specific reaction mechanisms. The reaction involved is either difficult or expensive to duplicate by classical chemical method. There has been a tremendous upsurge in the demand of phytopharmaceutical raw medicinal herbs and vegetable drugs of Indian origin from the Western nations. There is also increase in domestic demand for raw material used for perfumeries, pharmacies, and biopesticidal units. The demand for traditional herbal drugs is also increasing rapidly, mainly because of the harmful effects of synthetic chemical drugs, and also because of an expansion of pharmacies manufacturing natural drug formulations. Medicinal plant-based drug industries are like, there has been no much organized research set up to continually recharge scientific inputs in order to make the cultivation of medicinal plants not only economically viable but also more profitable, so that they can claim their due share in the cropping systems of the country. In spite of the thrust given by the government of India through the institutions like Center for Medicinal and Aromatic Plants, CIMAP, the Regional Research Laboratories, RRL, at Jammu, Bhubaneswar and Jorhat, Directorate of Medicinal and Aromatic Plants, DMAPR, National Botanical Gardens, Forest Research Institute, State Kinchona Directorates in Tamil Nadu and West Bengal, the replenishment of renewable inputs like quality planting material of improved varieties, developing extension literature, organizing training and quality testing are very limited because of the number of medicinal plants as well as their divergent uses. Difficulty in proper identification of medicinal plants has led to the use of adulterants or mimics. Physical verification is also a difficult proposition, mainly because the plant part used in many cases like the bark, roots, etc. show close resemblance. The only way to check adulterants would be by chemical examination. Aromatic plants. Out of nearly 450,000 species known to mankind, about 2,000 species, which come from about 60 botanical families, contain essential oils. The families Pinaceae, among the gymnosperms, Apiaceae, Rutaceae, Lauraceae, Lamiaceae, Poaceae, Arcaceae, Zingiberaceae, among the angiosperms, account for a large number of plants bearing essential oils of commercial importance. The volatile oil occur in varied parts of the plant anatomy, in some cases being found all over the plant body, in others being restricted to one special portion of the plant. Thus, in the conifers, of which the pine is a type, volatile oil is found all over the various parts, whereas in the rose, the oil is confined to the petals, in cinnamon to the bark and the leaves, in the orange family chiefly to the flowers and the peel of the fruit, in aromatic grasses and mints to the leaves, in ambrite, cumin, fennel, etc. in seeds, and in vetiver in the roots. In plants, these essential oils are produced in specialized glandular cells. In the case of the leaves and petals, the essential oils are contained in the innermost membrane of the cell wall in parenchymatous tissue. In other plants, they accumulate as floating drops in the protoplasm, such as terpenes in orange peels or in separate cell cavities. India has enjoyed a preeminent position in the manufacture of superior perfumes and aromatic scents ancient times, and the industry has flourished and grown considerably. The famous Chinese traveler Fa Hian described India as the land of aromatic flowers, fruits, woods, roots, resins, and grasses. Fragrances are very expensive and were used mostly in worship as incense. In ancient India, perfumers were important traders. They were called Gandhikas, who created their own blend of perfumes and incense in the form of liquid, sticks, powders, and pastes. In Sanskrit literature, there is description of the toilette of Mauryan queen, where her perfumes were freshly made by her maid. Sandalwood was grated on a whetstone, spices pounded in a pestle, then the paste blended in oil, and sweet-smelling flowers and leaves added to them. In the Ain-e-Akbari, Abul Fazl mentions Akbar's love of attar and incense, daily burned in gold and silver censer. At a later date, an apocryphal tale credits the Empress Nur Jahan with discovering the attar of roses. She is said to have noticed the rose oil floating on the surface of her bath water, and thus the legendary attar of rose was born. The world's total production of essential oil is estimated at about 1 lakh to 1 lakh 10,000 tons, and India stands third with a share of 16 to 17%. In the value terms again, India's position is number 2 and its share is 21 to 22%. This is because of the mint revolution in North India. Brazil, with its production of citrus oil at 40,000 tons, is the largest producer of essential oils in the world. However, its share in value terms is 90%, while USA is the largest producer and consumer of essential oils. Most of the essential oils produced are marketed within the country. Also, many of them are exported. These oils are very expensive and earn good revenue in terms of foreign exchange. In a simplified form, the compounds produced by living organisms are divided into two major groups, primary metabolites and secondary metabolites. The primary metabolites are produced in the basic metabolic process, that is primary metabolism, such as photosynthesis and respiration, and are considered essential functional operating components of all living organisms. Secondary metabolites are mostly derived from the precursors produced by the primary metabolic processes. Secondary metabolites have no generally recognized direct roles in the process of photosynthesis, respiration, and other major metabolic processes of the plants. Secondary metabolites also differ from primary metabolites in having a restricted distribution in the plant kingdom. In other words, particular secondary metabolites are often found in only one plant species or related group of species, whereas primary metabolites are often found throughout the plant kingdom. Medicinal aromatic plants contain chemical substances of different composition and activity. These are referred to as active or biologically active substances, implying their effect on living organisms. These substances play an important physiological and ecological role for the plant itself and are basis for their utilization as medicinal aromatic plants. It should, however, be underlined that plant metabolism cannot artificially be divided, as it involves both universal and special processes. In the scientific literature, active ingredients of plants are often still classified into four traditionally accepted groups: alkaloids, glycosides, essential oils, and other miscellaneous active substances. Alkaloids are a group of nitrogen-containing substances of basic chemical reaction. They frequently form salts and have strong physiological effects on living organisms. The alkaloids are very variable in their composition. Glycosides are compounds of various chemical structure and physiological effect and of divergent metabolic origin. Although generally not regarded as a uniform group of compounds, their common feature is that one or more identical sugar molecules are bound to a non-sugar type compound, a glycon. The glycons in turn can also be varied. The essential oil refers to a mixture of various compounds, mainly terpenes and terpene derivatives. The that evaporate at room temperature without residues. Frequently, they have characteristic and a strong odor and taste. Generally, they are extracted, isolated by steam distillation. They do not or only poorly dissolve in water. Miscellaneous substances like aromatic acids, bitter substances, carbohydrates, mucilaginous substances, plant pigments, rubber, sterols, tannins, vitamins cannot be classified into the above groups. They are of diverse chemical composition and physiological effectiveness. Many ancient plant remedies for disease have in some way or another played a significant role in the modern medicine. For example, aspirin is the most widely used medicine in the world and is entirely synthetic. But knowledge of the pain relieving agent we know today as aspirin is traceable to the use of willow bark by the ancient Greeks to alleviate pain. An active ingredient, salicin, was isolated in 1827 from the leaves of willow. Salicin could not be taken internally, but a derivative, acetyl salicylic acid, produced in Germany in 1899, provided relief from all types of pain. The point to be noted here is that the prototype of this drug was a natural product from plants. Similarly, a large number of drugs which are available in synthetic form today invariably have a botanical history in the use of some sort of crude extract. Modern drugs contain plant products like fatty acids and essential oils, gums, resins, alkaloids, and steroids. Oils and gums are used as emulsifiers in many of the present drug preparations. Volatile oils and resins are often used to help penetrate tissues and also as antiseptics. The two major classes of plant-derived compounds used in medicine are steroid alkaloids. They can occur with one or more sugar molecules attached. Such forms are called glycosides, and these are generally the medicinally active forms of the compound. Rowolfia. The genus Rowolfia was named after the 16th century German physician and explorer Dr. Leonhard Rowolf. The plant grows in tropical or subtropical regions. They are best raised from root cuttings. Seeds and stem cuttings are also used for propagation. Indonesia was once a major source, but it once extensively supply of trees and shrubs have been exhausted. Presently, the leading producers are India and Thailand. The Rowolfia species contain about 80 or more alkaloids, of which reserpine, resinamine, ajmaline, ajmalicine, and serpentine are of commercial importance. Of this, the most important is reserpine. It is chemically similar to serotonin, a substance in the brain, and is related to LSD, that is lysergic acid diethylamide. For centuries in India, powdered tap roots have been used for the treatment of moon disease or lunacy and also against snake bites, and the common name Chandrabhaga, Chota Chand or Satvaganda is named for this plant. Reserpine was also employed as medicine in US in the treatment of the mental disorder known as schizophrenia. As a result of the discovery that reserpine was hypotensive, that it could lower blood pressure, it found even greater use in the treatment of high blood pressure, often in combination with other drugs, than of schizophrenia. The use of reserpine in hypertension therapy is based on the action of the drug in dilating blood vessels and thereby reducing pressure. An extract of the leaves have also been used as a cure for the opacity of the cornea. Extracts of roots are used for intestinal disorders. Sometimes they are mixed with other plant extracts and used in the treatment of cholera, colic, and fever. Root extracts also stimulate uterine contraction and is used in childbirth. It enjoys a traditional reputation of a fever-reducing agent, or as an immunogogue, an agent that brings on menstruation. Indian aconite, with the botanical name aconitum ferox. Its origin is from temperate and subalpine regions of Himalaya. It grows in the moist, rich pastures and in mountain regions. It is propagated by tubers. These are dug when the plants start flowering. They are dried either in shade or in sunlight. Tubers are dark brownish with whitish internally. The aconite is very poisonous. It contains a toxic alkaloid, pseudoaconitine. When aconite is boiled in milk, its poisonous property is removed and is then used as a diuretic, antiarthritic, expectorant, narcotic, nervine toxin. Its homeopathic preparations are taken for neuralgia and chills. Quinine tree. The origin is from Andean region, the South America, from Bolivia to Colombia. The alkaloids occur in the bark of the roots, trunks, and branches. The roots contain the highest concentration of total alkaloids. About 30 alkaloids have been isolated. But the bark of the trunk is the richest source of quinine. Quinine is isomer quinidine, cinchonine, and its isomer cinchonidine. All four are collectively known as tetraquine. The alkaloids exist in the bark in combination with cinchotannic acid, quinic acid, free organic acids, tannins, coloring matters, gum, starch, vegetable matter, and traces of volatile oil. Quinine is used for the treatment of malaria. Quinidine is used today to treat abnormal rhythms of the heart, to relieve muscle cramps, and to aid in the treatment of headaches. Quinine, quinidine, and their compounds are employed in insecticides for the preservation of fur, feathers, wool, etc. The residual bark of cinchona left after the extraction of alkaloids is used as a tanning agent. Yams are deeply rooted, climbing, dioecious, perennial vines. Rhizome is modified to produce an annual tuber. Size varies from a small potato to those of weighing as much as 45 kg. Internally, the yam is white, although few are purplish or yellowish and may be coarse, dry, mealy, tender, crisp, or mushy. They mature in 8 to 10 months. Each tuber usually produces only one main stem, which may branch. Small tubers, tuber cuttings, that is the tip or crown of the tuber containing buds or eyes, or bulbils are used for vegetative propagation. The bulbils are really used for the propagation. Fresh tubers of most species may be bitter or even poisonous because of the presence of certain alkaloids or oxalic acid and oxalates. They are more nutritious than cassava because they are rich in proteins and vitamin C. The average composition of fresh yam is water 60-70%, carbohydrates 15-25%, and proteins 4-8%. Wild species contain diosgenin. Diosgenin proved suitable to serve as the starting steroid nucleus from which a variety of valuable and steroid compounds could be manufactured. Example, cortisone, hydrocortisone, and sex hormones such as androgens and progesterone. The botanical name of yam is Dioscorin. Most of the hormones synthesized from diosgenin are used in birth control pills, for the production of hormones to regulate menstruation cycles, or as a component of fertility drugs. Cortisone and hydrocortisone are the two other hormones that are synthesized from the diosgenin. They are used for the treatment of severe allergenic reactions, for arthritis, and for Addison's disease, caused by malfunction of the adrenal gland. Yams are a source of carbohydrate food and are more nutritious than cassava because they have more proteins. They are not left bitter after they have been peeled, boiled, or roasted. Fufu, a dish prepared by grinding fresh yams, is prized in West African homes. Belladonna, with the botanical name Atropa belladonna. The plants are raised from seeds. Vegetative propagation is done through pruning of old rootstocks. The soil should be calcareous, containing decomposed humus and good quantity of minerals like potash and soda. All parts of the plant contain alkaloids, but are more abundant in the physiologically active cells. The leaves and tops are collected during the flowering season when the alkaloidal concentration is maximum, 0.9 to 1.23%. A large number of alkaloids, collectively known as belladonna alkaloids, have been isolated from this plant. Atropine, its isomer, hyoscyamine, and scopolamine are the three most important alkaloids. Ophthalmologists or eye specialists use atropine to dilate pupils for eye examination. They are basic ingredient in the preparation of medicine for colic and peptic ulcers. Externally, belladonna ointment is occasionally applied to treat gout or rheumatism. The belladonna alkaloids are prescribed for victims of Parkinson's disease to decrease stiffness and tremor. These alkaloids are also given to patients before surgery as a relaxant and to reduce salivation. They are also helpful in cases of mushroom poisoning. Foxglove. For cultivation, disease-free strains of the seeds are selected to produce healthy plants. Soils should contain manure and leaf mold. Seedlings are hand transplanted. The first year leaves contain the highest percentage of glycosides. Harvesting is done before the flowering and then they are thoroughly dried at temperature not exceeding 600 degrees Celsius. The active constituents of digitalis are mainly confined to the epidermal and subepidermal collenchyma and the endodermal cells. Digitalis purpurea leaves contain 0.2 to 0.45% of a mixture of cardinolides. The physiologically active glycoside digitoxin, gitoxin, and gitalin are derived from the naturally occurring purpurea glycoside A, purpurea glycoside B, and purpurea glycoside C, respectively, by the loss of the glucose residue. Cardiac glycosides have a strong effect on the cardiac heart muscles. When used medicinally, they can also improve circulation in general, relieve edema, which is often associated with heart failure, help renal secretion. Periwinkle, with the botanical name Catharanthus roseus, fresh seeds are used for propagation. The interest of the scientific community arose in the 1915 after hearing of a periwinkle tea that was drunk in Jamaica for its anti-diabetic properties. All parts of the plant contain alkaloids, but leaves are used as a commercial source for the isolation of the two important anti-cancer alkaloids, vinpristine and vinblastine. These are known to inhibit the growth of tumors. Today, we know that periwinkle is endowed with other medicinal properties. In all, it contains more than 90 non-alkaloid agents. Vinblastine sulfate is mainly used for the treatment of Hodgkin's disease, that is the cancer of the lymphatic system. Vinblastine sulfate is useful for leukemia in children and lymphocytic leukemia. Long before modern researchers learned of the plant's medicinal properties, Fog killers in faraway places used in Madagascar periwinkle for a number of medicinal uses. In India, wasp sting was treated with the juice from the leaves. In Hawaii, an extract of the boiled plant was used to stop bleeding. In Central America, it was used for gargle, to ease throats, sore throats, and chest ailments. In Cuba, Jamaica, and other islands, an extract of the flowers are commonly used as an eye wash. Opium poppy. Opium is a complex blend of dextrose, pectin, wax, pigments, volatile oil, triterpenoid, and alkaloids, occurring as salt derived from a number of acids, including meconic, lactic, citric, succinic, sulfuric, and phosphoric acid. The seeds of the opium poppy are free from narcotic constituents. In an attempt to develop a non-addicting painkiller, scientists discovered that morphine could be chemically altered by addition of two acetyl groups. The end product is a semi-synthetic compound known as heroin. It is an even more powerful analgesic than morphine, but it's physically addicting and produces pronounced withdrawal symptoms once the habit has been established. The main cause of death for heroin addicts is by overdose. Morphine is a powerful analgesic and narcotic, which also stimulates the central nervous system. Codeine is an important analgesic and anti-cough agent, which compared with morphine is less sedative and less toxic. Sebine is a convulsant that induces violent irregular motions of the body, poison, and is used only as a raw material for the manufacturing of codeine or other semi-synthetic analgesics and narcotic antagonists, such as nalorphine and atorphine. Narcotine is a mild antitussive and is generally used in the preparation of cough medicines. Papaverine is a smooth muscle relaxant and cerebral vasodilator. It has been used in the treatment of asthma and angina pectoris. The poppy seeds are quite nutritious and have a pleasant nutty flavor and are often sprinkled on breads and cakes. These seeds are also a source of fatty oil called poppy oil, used in the preparation of sweetmeats. Next, vomica. The seeds contain two powerful alkaloids, 1.5 to 3.5%, strychnine and brucine. Strychnine is extremely bitter and can be tasted even when diluted in a solution that is 4 lakh parts water. Other parts such as old roots, wood, bark, leaves, blossoms, and the fruit pulp also contain varying amounts of alkaloids. Strychnine is both a stimulant, enhances the sensation of sight, smell, touch, and hearing, that is, it affects the central nervous system, and it is also a convulsant or an agent that causes uncontrolled fits or spasms. Its action can be instantaneous. Strychnine is used in controlled doses to increase muscular activity. It is also an antidote to poisoning caused by alcohol and other depressant drugs. Because it tends to induce intestinal movement, physicians have selectively administered the drug in the treatment of severe constipation. Strychnine is commercially used in preparation of pellets used as a poison for mold called mold nuts or poison peanuts. The fruit pulp is non-poisonous and is eaten by birds, cattle, and monkeys. Ergot, with a botanical name Calvisus purpurea, ergot is rich in many types of alkaloids, some of which are toxic and others are medicinally valuable. Ergotoxin, ergotamine, and ergonovine are some of the important alkaloids isolated from ergot fungus, and lysergic acid diethylamide is one of the worst habit-forming drugs known. It is also suspected of causing chromosomal aberrations. Ergot also contains clarithrin, a red or violet pigment, ergosterol, clavicepsin, ergocrisin, ergoflavin, inorganic salts, and large number of bases and amino acids. The ergot alkaloids and related compounds are toxic and are capable of inducing varied effects, including hallucination, and cause a disease known as ergotism. When contaminated rye is harvested and ground into flour, the sclerotia is also get ground with it. Clavicus purpurea produces sclerotia, which contains alkaloids that stop the bleeding. These agents are widely used to control hemorrhages after childbirth. It is used extensively to increase the blood pressure as a hypertensive agent. It is also used in psychiatry. Two kinds of oil are produced by plants: fixed oil and essential oils. The fixed non-volatile oils are usually food reserves, and these are commercially important. They are produced in plants through the synthesis of fatty acids from carbohydrates, and three molecules of fatty acids combine with glycerol to form triglycerides. Therefore, the fixed plant oils are two glycerides of saturated and unsaturated organic acids. Even among species of the same genus, different kinds of oils may be stored. The variation is due to the fact that vegetable oil is a mixture of different fatty acids, which vary in the degree in which they are saturated, degree to which they are saturated. That is, they differ in the number of double bonds in their molecules. The less saturated fatty acids in the oil, the less stable it is in air, and the more readily it is oxidized to form a thin, elastic, waterproof surface film. Essential oils are a mixture of highly aromatic, steam-volatile organic compounds obtained from plants. During the Middle Ages, throughout Europe, pharmacists explored the medicinal properties of the wide variety of plants and began the research for the essential principle of plant tissues, which they believed was responsible for the curative effects on the human body. By the process of steam distillation from different plants, a number of pleasant-smelling, highly volatile liquids are obtained. These were considered essential constituents of the plant, and hence the term essential oil, which has persisted to the present day. Essential oils are isolated from various parts of the plant. For bark, in the case of cinnamon, root, vetiver, rhizomes, in the case of ginger, from the wood, in the case of sandalwood, and from the flower, in the case of rose, jasmine, tuberose, violet, and in the case of orange, it's from fruit, and in the case of nutmeg, it is from isolated from seeds. Essential oil is a mixture of wide variety of natural organic compounds and chemicals of several functional groups and molecular structure. Over 200 components may be present in an essential oil, and the characteristic order may depend on trace amounts of one or several compounds. The most important chemical constituents are the terpenes. They are hydrocarbons made of isoprene units and exist as unsaturated straight chain molecules or as ring structures, and readily combine with other organic compounds. Most essential oils also contain camphor, and the more odoriferous compounds present consist of oxygen derivatives of terpenes, alcohols, esters, aldehydes, and ketones. The essential oils promote insect pollination because their scent attracts them to the plant as protection aid against animals and parasites, and in allopathic strategies. It acts as a wood fluid. Example, oleoresinous extrudes of certain plants act as protective seals against pathogen and insects when the plants are wounded. It serves as reserve food substances. It has role in water conservation by reducing the transpiration rate due to their heart screening effect. They are byproducts of the general metabolism of the plant that after having fulfilled some functions, example, acting as hydrogen donors in oxidation reduction reaction, are then stored by the plant in such a manner and in such tissues as to isolate them from the main centers of metabolic activity. They are important ingredients of spices, cosmetics, perfumes, and natural food flavoring. They are used in aromatherapy. They have bacteriostatic and other bactericidal properties. They are used in the preparation of antiseptics, insecticides, and aerosols. The sandalwood, botanical name Santalum album. The major aromatic constituents are: the fragrance of sandalwood oil is because of the presence of a mixture of alpha and beta santalols. Sulfuterpene alcohol with 90 to 95%. The other constituents are santalal, santalone, and santine. Sandalwood oil is used for the preparation of oriental perfumes. The oil is also used for the manufacturing of soaps, talcum powders, creams, hair oils, and hand lotions. The oil is also used in medicine for its cooling, diaphoretic, that stimulates perspiration, as diuretic, increases urination, and expectorant properties, promote ejection of phlegm or mucus from the chest. The paste of wood is applied in case of headache, also used in religious ceremonies. Seeds yield an oil which is used in skin troubles. Sandalwood is one of the finest wood for carving. Its sawdust is used as incense for scenting clothes and cupboards. Vetiver, with botanical name Vetiveria zizaniodus. Vetiver often grows on river banks up to an altitude of 600 meters. It requires a hot and humid climate. It should be grown on sandy soils. Vetiver is propagated by roots, which are separated and planted at a distance of 40 centimeters. The source of oil is: roots are harvested 15 to 24 months after planting. The major aromatic constituents are: vetiver oil is a viscid, dark oil with a sweet, persistent color. The principal constituents is vetivetol, vetivinyl, vetivinate, and alpha-beta vetivonus are also said to be responsible for the characteristic odor. The oil content of the dried root is 0.5 to 3%. The roots are used for making screens, mats, pillows, hand fans, and cooling jackets during hot, dry summer months. They are also sometimes put with clothes because of their scent and in the belief that they repel insects. Vetiver oil is often used as a fixative for more volatile constituents, for scenting soaps, and in preparation of cosmetics. The grass is widely used for planting on the counter as an anti-erosion measure, for protective partition in terraced fields, and as a border for roads and gardens. It is also used for making sherbets. Besides sandalwood and vetiver, a large number of essential oil-yielding plants are used in a number of ways, and this forms an important part of our culture. Goodbye for today. Continue your studies with iiocs.com for tech law. For any queries, contact the number on the screen.